So hopefully Buddy didn't move too much, and I keep this in the camera here. All I did was trim that from the bottom. Come on, buddy. Give me that foot. I know. So this was the broken part. You can tell once I trimmed off the edge, it's a little higher. So that's gonna have to grow down. But all I'm gonna do is kinda round this foot off here. I don't wanna take too much. He's got a really long toe here. And because his feet are wet, because it's been muddy, this rasp works so much easier. And it makes the hoof soft. The problem with that is you can take a lot off pretty quick. So you don't want to press real hard when the hoof's wet. So I'm just going to kind of round that off a little bit. Make this as round as I can. I'm not going to bring the hoof wall all the way up to that crack, because crack's a little high. But he's giving me kisses. So I'm just gonna round this off. There's a little bitty high spot right there. I'm putting the rasp flat, and I can tell there's a high spot right there. Got a little flare because his toe came out. So I'm gonna take that down, and again, there's different philosophies on that. Never trim this wall. If you trim it too much, it compromises it, it makes it thin, it lets bacteria in. So I don't mess with the hoof wall a whole bunch, but if I've got a high spot like that, I'm gonna take it down a little bit. Now I'm gonna use a smooth side. I'm just gonna round this off. And if you look at the other video, that crack looked pretty bad. But because the hoof was long, he's been in the mud in the winter. And now, it's almost gone. And that'll just heal up okay. Put your foot down, boy. He's like, Dad, where's my cookie? I didn't move. I was a good boy. You were a good boy. That means you don't get a beating. So, if you can tell, if you go back to the other video, that was pretty bad. And again, I could take more off, but I'm not really worried about it. I could make that look prettier for me, but the hoof is pretty level on the bottom. I took the wall off and I rounded the edge, and that's all I'm going to do for that. And again, you know, his feet are soft because it's wet. People don't realize that. When you ride a horse and it's wet, especially if they have shoes with nails, the moisture gets in there, it rots the nails, it rots the hoof. Horseshoes are just so bad in so many ways for horses. And you got these farriers out here that make a living on it, you know. You don't ask a barber if you need a haircut. You know, you don't ask a farrier if your horse needs shoes. Now, I know there's some good farriers out there who don't put them unless they need them and they don't like them and they're barefoot trimmers and blah, blah, but there's a whole bunch of others, and I've met more kind of crooked farriers, which is kind of sad, but I mean, that's just the horse world. I think there's more bad in the horse world than there is good. People out trying to make a buck, fool people, put out false information, all kind of things. So that's just in the horse world, period, not just farriers. That's with trainers, sports, judges, racing, you name it. If it's involving horses, there's a lot of crooked people in it making money off the stupid. And so you can tell the other foot now, I don't know if you can see that, let me move over here a little bit. The other foot, I did not trim it yet. All I did was cut from the bottom. And I know it's in the shade, but I still need to round that off from the top like I did on the other one and take off those edges, and then that one will look smooth, pretty much like this one. There's a little, looking at that rubber there, because he's standing on rubber, it looks like it's a little high on that toe where that flare's at. I might just take a little rasp right there. But as far as the chip side over there, I'm not going to mess with it. It's just going to grow back out and heal. Don't need to call a vet. I don't need a special shoe. I don't need to wrap it. All these people putting conditioner and this, that, and this. You need to put this on it. You need to wrap it. Look, if Buddy was out in the wild right now, which he kind of is out here running around, he just doesn't get to travel as far or over different terrain, so he's in the mud a lot. His feet would naturally sculpt. Is it the best? No. Obviously, you want to trim them out every once in a while. You had to knock that over, didn't you? You just had to get a beating. Couldn't fit in a video without getting a beating. All right. We'll end that there before I go off my rant with these farriers trying to rip people off, telling people what they need, and got all these silly new horse owners. 90% of them are women. I know. I hate women. Whatever. 90% of them are women. They don't know much. They get a horse. They think it wants to look pretty, so they're putting all this conditioner, doing everything, calling the farrier, listen to them. My horse needs shoes. You know, they ride the horse maybe twice a year, and then they ride it around an arena on dirt, and the farrier's got them convinced they need shoes because the horse is limping because I trimmed it so short that I made your horse limp, and you're too stupid to know, so you think the horse needs shoes. All right. That's my rant on farriers. Some farrier's going to come on here and tell me. Some farrier already did come on here and go, dude, you need to get a farrier. You don't know what you're doing. All right, whatever. My horses seem to be doing okay. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, you're a good boy sometime.